Hey friends, in this video, we are going to learn about rule of 17 for cranial nerves. And also, we'll see the concept behind it. So do watch the full video for complete understanding. First of all, what is rule of 17? As you can see, 10 plus 7 is 17 and also 12 plus 5 is 17. So in case of 10th and 7th nerve palsy, the affected structure will deviate to opposite side. And in case of 12th and 5th nerve palsy, the affected structures will deviate to same side. The reason for these deviations we'll learn for each nerve separately. First of all, 10th cranial nerve, that is vagus nerve. In case of lesion, there's deviation of uvula towards the opposite side of lesion, that is towards normal side. For example, if there is lesion on left side, deviation of uvula will be there towards the right side, as you can see in this figure. The reason is pharyngeal muscles becomes weak on affected side, and there is contraction of muscles of non-affected sides causes unopposed pull of uvula, which will cause deviation away from the lesion. Next is 7th cranial nerve, that is facial nerve. Here, lesion will cause deviation of angle of mouth towards opposite side of lesion. For example, if there is lesion on right side of the cranial nerve or right facial nerve, there will be deviation of angle of mouth to the left. The reason is, as ipsilateral muscles are paralyzed, face will be deviated to opposite side because levator anguli oris holds or pulls the muscle on the same side. So this is the levator anguli oris, whose normal function is to elevate the angle of mouth. So if there is lesion on the right side, left sided muscle is functioning, which will cause elevation or deviation of mouth towards the opposite side. So these two cranial nerves, that is 10th and 7th, we saw this deviation of affected structures towards the opposite side of lesion. Next is 12th cranial nerve, that is hypoglossal nerve. It supplies genioglossus muscle, whose normal function is to protrude the tongue, that is, it has the pushing function. So in case of lesion, there is deviation of tongue towards the side of lesion. It is because of unopposed action of normal genioglossus muscle. For example, if lesion is there on the left side, there is deviation of tongue also to the left. The reason, as I told, because of unopposed action of contralateral or normal genioglossal muscle, it pushes the muscle to opposite side, that is the same side of lesion. And the last is 5th cranial nerve, that is trigeminal nerve. It normally supplies lateral pterygoid muscle, whose normal function is to protrude and depress the jaw, that is also has pushing function. So in case of lesion, there is deviation of jaw towards the side of lesion because of unopposed action of normal lateral pterygoid muscle. As you can see in this figure, if lesion is there on the left side, there is deviation of jaw also towards left. The reason, as I told, because of unopposed action of normal or contralateral lateral pterygoid muscle, which pushes the muscle to opposite side, jaw deviates to the same side of the lesion, that is to the left side. So guys, this was all about this video. I hope I was able to clear concepts. I am sure this concept will help you in clinics as well as in the exams like NEET PG to solve the MCQs without mugging. I hope you liked the video. Subscribe the channel for further interesting and conceptual videos. And also share the video to clear the concept of your fellow mates. Let the knowledge spread.